In this video, I'll show you how to draw this cute mushroom illustration step by step. Before we start, you can download the color palette and the custom brushes I used in the video description below. If you enjoy learning Procreate with me, make sure to check my Patreon, where you can support me and access more exclusive tutorials and brushes. Without any further delay, let's begin! As always, in the beginning, I'm going to change the background color. This time I will select a very dark shade, maybe even black, because I will be using these light colors to draw the mushroom, and I want it to be seen clearly. So let me now go to the color palette and pick the color that comes first in this row. We are going to draw the mushroom's body. And first we will create a rounded rectangle or square. I will be doing it in the following way. Go to calligraphy set and duplicate monoline brush here. I will open it, go to properties and change maximum and minimum size values. I will set maximum size to 400% and minimum size to 40%. Click Done. Now I will set the brush size to 14% and draw a horizontal line somewhere in the middle of the canvas. I will tap to make it strictly horizontal. After that, I will duplicate it and rotate this one to 90 degrees. I will click on this green circle and enter 90 here. Now I will go to snapping and enable it in the settings. I will move this line to create this angle. If it doesn't match 100%, you can tap once or twice to move it. After that, I will merge these two layers, duplicate it, click on the arrow, and flip this angle horizontal and vertical. I will also tap to move it to the left. Just a couple of times. Now we got this rounded square. I'm merging these layers and filling the area inside it, adjusting the color drop threshold. After we made this square, I will move it to the left with the snapping to center it. And now let's draw the head. For that, I will create a new layer and pick this red. I will be using normal monoline brush for drawing with the size set to 1%. I will draw a circle that is a little bigger than the square on the sides. Also tap on the canvas to make it perfect. I will fill it and then go and move it like this, so its center matches with the center of the square vertically. All right. Now I will click on this S icon, pick rectangle from the menu, and select the part of the circle below the intersection. Then I will swipe three fingers down and cut this part. We got these basic shapes. And now we can transform them. First, I will go to the square. And actually, we can move them a bit up. I'll be using magnetics. Alright. Now I will go to the square and apply warp. I will drag the lower edge a bit down to make it more round. Now let's transform the head. And we'll be doing it in a few steps. First, I will go and rotate it, just a tiny bit, without magnetics or snapping. It shows 93%. I will move it to the left and make the edges match. Alright, now let's go to warp. I will drag this side a little down here. And this side will go a little up. I will also drag the upper edge a little down. Let me move this one a bit to the right. Maybe even more on the left. I will also drag the lower edge a little up. Up, up, up. Now I will move the entire head down slightly. After we did that, I will pick eraser, set to monoline brush. And we will define the lower edge more. I will make a short line going up on this side. Here I'll make it match and draw a vertical line with the eraser too. Only on the white part. And from here I will draw an arc. This way. Let me match it here. Alright, and I want to erase this part. So I will go to Selection, pick Automatic, tap on this part that we want to remove, swipe three fingers down and cut it. I will only erase this line left from Selection. You can use your own way to erase this part. It's just one of the ways. Well, now I will use Liquify to fix the edges on the sides. And this one is fine. Now I will create a layer between these two and select this green. We will draw what we call in Russia under head. So on this side, I will draw a line outside the white area that will go approximately till the middle of this distance. This way. We can edit this line. After that, I will draw another line on the opposite side. It will be a bit shorter. Now we need to connect these two lines with an arc. And to fill this shape, we need to close the invisible part of it. So I will outline it here, then drag the color inside it. We got the basic shapes. I will just select these two and with magnetics drag them slightly down, because the lower face of a character, the more cute it looks. It's like when you are drawing a baby face. These proportions are fine. Now we can shade it. I want to start with the head, but before shading, let's add these white spots on it. So I'm going to the disk and double tapping on the white area. The white color is selected. And I will use this newly created monoline brush. We just need to find the suitable size for it. Let it be 40%. So I will create a new layer above the head and tap somewhere in the middle. After that, I will tap four more times. Here, then a bit lower, and on the left side. If you want to move one of the circles, you can go to Selection, pick Freehand, outline it, and then move. I will also move this one. Now I will do this. Click on the arrow and select Warp. I want to make the circles match with the head shape. So I will first widen this circle in the middle. Then also make this grid follow the shape of the head. On the sides, here on the left, and here. All right, now let's try to clip this layer and see. It is fine. I will just move the middle circle a bit down. Now that's better. We can shade it. I'm not going to apply any blending modes or change the shading anyhow, so I will go to this layer and simply alpha lock it. In the color palette, I will select a darker shade of red. For shading, I will be using one of the Procreate charcoal brushes. It is called Vine Charcoal. The brush opacity is at 75%. And the size is at around 30%. Let's first draw on the left side of the head, not pressing too much on the pencil. I'm drawing almost on the half of it. And after that, I will switch to a darker shade of red. Paint more on this side to darken it more. After that, I will lower the size to around 7% and draw along the lower edge. This way. Following the shapes. Also this arc. This way we are creating volume. I will press more right on the edge, but still keep the texture. Alright, now that we have the shadows, we also need to add highlights, and I will be using white color, so I can pick it right from this circle. And I will also be doing it on the same layer, only increasing the brush size, and I will lower the opacity to 60%. First, I will draw on the left side, on the edge, going down here. After that, I will increase the brush size a little and draw on the right edge, highlighting it between the circles and going down here. Alright, this part is done. Now we can shade this green area. I will also be doing it right on the layer, so I'm locking it to keep my strokes within the shape. And I will start with this dark green. First, I will go with this color along the upper edge of the green shape. The brush size is at around 15%, or maybe even less. Let's make it 10%. And see. It works better. So I'm drawing on the edge, going to the right, and adding this cast shadow. I will continue here. And follow this arc. Alright. Now I will also make the brush size 2% and shade this small area here. Going along the lower edge now, but not all over it. I will just add the color here. Then skip a part and continue drawing from the middle, going to the right. Here I will make the brush size smaller and press more. Going to the side. Now let's add some light shades. I want to use white again, picking it from here, and I will start adding the color in this gap first. The brush size can be even 1%, because this gap is very small. I will continue going to the right. Then on the lower edge. This way. Going to the right. I will highlight this area, just a tiny angle. And make a few strokes in this gap. I will press here more. Alright, I think this is also done. Before shading the mushroom itself, let's draw the eyes and other details. I'll be doing it on a separate layer. Let's create it above the body. And I will pick black color first, right from the background. For the eyes, I will select our new monoline to make it in one stroke. I will make the size 13% and I will draw only one eye, then duplicate it. So let it be the right one. I will just tap here to get this circle. After that, I will alpha lock this eye and first pick this green color. I will also be using this brush from charcoals that we used for shading the head. Let's make the size around 8% and draw on the lower half of the eye, making the strokes inwards. After that, I will pick a lighter shade of green from here and draw more on the edge. This way we are also creating volume. After we highlighted the edge, we can add light reflections with a white color. Let's do it on a separate layer, so it will be easier to move the reflections if we place them wrong. In this case, we can use monoline from Procreate. I will make the brush size 60% and tap here After that, I will make the size 16% and create one more circle here at some distance. Let's merge these two layers and I will move it closer to the center. I think this is fine. Now let's just duplicate this eye. Enable magnetics and drag this eye carefully to the left to make it symmetrical, so we have same distance between the eyes and the edges. I will move it more. This is better. We can totally merge these layers and create a new one for the mouth. I will pick black color from the background again and change the brush to Studio Pen because it has these sharp tips. The size can be 7%. I will first draw an arc with an angle. And then another one. I will edit it and fill. Let's create a new layer above this one and pick this red from the first column. I will clip this layer and draw a shape this way, consisting of two arcs. I will close the invisible part of this shape and fill it. Let me select these two. And I will adjust its shape quickly. All right. Let me go to this layer and alpha lock it. To shade it quickly, I will be using this dark red between these two. And our texture brush, drawing on the lower edge. And now we can shade it. I will also be doing it on the layer. So I'm locking it and I will do it gradually, starting with this color. I will increase the brush size to 20% and draw on the left side first. Also at the bottom, then on the right. We can make strokes vertically and inwards to keep the texture. Let's also draw on top of the shape. After that, I will switch to a darker shade, this one. And apply this color on the left side, but on smaller area. So I'm drawing closer to the edge. Going down and to the right. I will also paint on top, but smaller area as well. To create more volume, this color is applied. Let's go even darker. So I'm picking this brown. I will first make the size smaller and draw only along the upper edge to make the cast shadow that comes from the head. Then I will draw on the sides like triangles, but not pressing on the pencil in order not to make it too dark. On this side and also here, also making a triangle. The shading part here is done. I will pick white and draw on the left edge to add reflected light. But I'm not going on this angle, starting from here. All right. Let's not forget to shade the area around the eyes. So I will first pick this color and draw on top of the eyes. Let's make the size 8%. And I'm making these circular strokes. First eye and the second one. After that, I will pick this dark brown and draw more on the edge. We can make the brush size smaller here too. And draw this way to create volume and depth. Doing the same for the second eye. All right, let's add a small detail on the mouth. I will switch back to this color and create a new layer. Also pick studio pen from inking. I will just draw two small water drop shapes on these corners. Then go and apply Gaussian blur on it. Around 2.2%. I think this mushroom looks cute. Let's continue working. And we can already merge all the layers for the mushroom. It's time to create a background. For that, I will add a new layer above the mushroom, and we actually can scale it a bit. I think it got too big. That's way better. I will be using these three colors to draw the leaves, starting from the green in the middle. And I will be using one of the brushes from my botanics set. It is grass blade textured. I'll make the size 45% and draw an arc from left to right. I will go to the new layer and draw an arc, lowering the pressure in the end to make this tip sharp. To make the leaf less transparent, we can duplicate it and merge. I want to transform it to give it more three-dimensional look. And I will be doing it using the warp tool again. I will drag the tip down like this and also move this shape up. All right. I will shade the leaf on a separate layer that I will create above it and clip. First, I will select a darker shade of green. Let me go to selection, pick freehand, and I will do this. I will continue this line here, then just outline the shape and close it. I will click on the brush and select our shading brush, that is Vine Charcoal. I will increase the size and shade this edge. First, painting slightly, and on the edge I will apply more pressure to darken it more. Let's deselect. I will increase the size to 28% and first shade the leaf here, go to the right, after that paint on top. Here. Then I will switch to the light green. I will highlight the tip and also this part. This leaf is done. I'm not merging the layers yet. I will duplicate the base layer and drag this one on top, then unclip. I will drag it down and shade it in another way. I will first create a layer above it and also clip. Let's change the color right away to the dark green. And we have same brush. I will go to selection. And this time I will continue this line. And go on the leaf this way. Close it, click on the brush, and I will shade this part to create a shadow, pressing more on the edge. Alright, let me deselect. As you see, with the same leaf, but with different shading, we got different three-dimensional look. I will lower the brush size here and draw slightly on this edge. After that, I will switch to a lighter shade of green, paint here and also on this tip. After that, we can merge these two pairs of layers, these two and then these. I will drag the upper layer below the mushroom. I will click on the arrow and flip it horizontal. I will use warp tool to change the leaf shape a bit. I want this dark edge to be seen more. So I will transform it this way, move it a bit down, and I will shade this part with a dark green color. Now we can just alpha lock it, and I will paint more here to add the shadow from the mushroom. And we can rotate it. Don't let the leaf go outside the borders of the canvas, because we will need it. Alright, now that we have these two leaves, we can add the background. I will create a new layer that I will place right above the background layer. And I will select this dark green. Let's use the same brush from Botanics set. It is grass blade textured. I will draw a few leaves growing in different directions. Alright, now I will select this green in the middle and make a few strokes. Just to add some color variations. Alright, after that I will apply Gaussian blur on this layer, around 6 or 7%. And we can duplicate it. I will go to the layer below and make it bigger. We can also flip it horizontal and move. Try to fill more black gaps. That's it. Let's merge these two layers. Now we have four elements, and I want to place them all in one shape. So let me create a new layer and place it below all layers. I will pick this color. And let's toggle the visibility of all layers for now, so they don't distract us. In calligraphy, I will select monoline and draw a circle. I will tap on the canvas. And fill it. If we click on this arrow, enable snapping and move it to the left, we can place it in the center vertically, and I will keep a small gap on top. Now I will create a layer above it. Go to selection, pick rectangle and color fill. Let's draw a rectangular shape. This way. It will be filled straight away. If it doesn't match 100% with the circle, we can go to the arrow and with the snapping, pick freeform and make this rectangle match. Now all the edges match perfectly. Let's merge these two layers. And then I will bring back the layer with the background leaves. Let's try to clip it. And I will scale it without snipping. All right. Now let's bring back the remaining layers and see what we got. I think the mushroom size is fine. I just want to rotate this leaf a bit more. And transform this one a little. I will move it up this way. Let's remove the parts of the leaves that we don't want to see. These are outside the shape. So I will first go to this layer, select rectangle, and disable color fill. I will select this part and cut it. Let's do the same for the second leaf. I will go to selection, outline it here, cut, and erase the part on the circle manually. Let's make these leaves more symmetrical to balance the illustration. Now that's better. I want to add a few more details. So let's merge all these layers. I will create a new layer above it. Pick this green. And grass blade again. I will get this layer selected. Go back to the new layer and I will draw a leaf this way. I will duplicate it, merge these two layers, alpha lock it, and add a dark shade to it quickly with our texture brush. I'll start from here and go a little on top. I will duplicate it one more time. Now that's better. After we made all these manipulations, We can totally change the background color. And I will select this one. What is missing here is the shadow that comes from the leaf on the mushroom's head. So I will create a new layer. Since we already have all the layers merged, I will do this. I will pick this color, set the layer to multiply, and I will use soft brush. Just draw slightly on the head. Try not to go outside its shape. And now our cute illustration is ready. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't. Also, I'd love it if you tag me in your Instagram posts. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video.